Good afternoon, lacrosse fans. Welcome to Bee Field at Piper Stadium in beautiful but snowy Granville, Ohio. My name is Nick Merritt, and I am joined alongside Lily Greenhead, and you are watching the Denison Sports Network's presentation of the visiting Oberlin Yale women as they take on your Denison Big Reds. Lily, can you give us some keys to join for the 7-2 Yale women?
Thank you, Nick. Denison's Big Red is coming off a one-goal loss to Mount Union, and earlier this season, Oberlin also lost to Mount Union by a one-goal difference at 8-9. So hopefully we'll be seeing a similar competitive matchup today. Oberlin is home to a senior Grace Tyler, a leading scorer for Oberlin with 30 goals this season, as well as sophomore number 20, Mary Lacrosse. We had 36 goals, so they'll be something to definitely look out for during this game today. And Oberlin also has an incredibly strong squad on the teams, and this is something that Grace can capitalize on to maintain position throughout the game.
So thanks, Roy. Now for this 4-5 Big Red. Coming off a heartbreaking career against the Mountain Union Pistolators, the Big Red are looking to bank on the win streak as they play the second of this current series in their home state. For some analysis, the first thing you need to do is get the free position opportunities. They were successful on 56% of them this year, and 6 of their 12 goals against Mountain Union on Wednesday came on these chances. Secondly, Oberlin Power scores on average an impressive 14 goals a game, as they have a very high-powered offense. The Big Red need to impress them on their wide to limit those opportunities. Lastly, Claire Ledwell, with a team leading 29 points, needs to continue being the top offensive coach of the year as she is coming out of a 5-goal performance. We're going to take a short break here. Thank you for watching the Denison Sports Network. And welcome back. This is Nick Martin alongside Lily Greenhead, and you are currently watching the Denison Sports Network. Now for today's starting lineup. For the Oberlin Yale women, number 2, senior defender, Taylor Swift. Junior, number 4, midfielder, Michaela Peterberg. Freshman midfielder, Haley Jason. Junior midfielder, number 7, Hannah Heinze Green. Junior attacker, number 8, Maggie Mullig. Senior midfielder, number 10, Susanna Drake. Number 17, junior midfielder, Swain Gerlich. Freshman midfielder, number 20, Natalie Wackler. Number 21, junior attacker, Marissa Mossfield. Number 24, freshman defender, Sydney Young. Number 33, Grace Barlow, a senior move. And in goal, number 32, a junior, Alexa Wettenfeladis. Lily, for the Denison Big Red?
Yes, for the Denison Big Red, today we have sophomore midfielder, number 3, Holly West. Junior midfielder, number 6, Claire Budswell. Junior midfielder, number 7, Reed Hayes. Senior attacker, number 8, Ruby Tarleton. Senior attacker, number 11, Tara Adam. Freshman defender, number 13, Emily Fenneman. Freshman defender, number 15, Jim Gertzley. Junior attacker, number 18, Emily Fenneman. Sophomore midfielder, number 19, Leah Israel. Sophomore defender, number 23, Grace Cabrillo. And sophomore defender, number 25, Emily Maya. And in goal, sophomore number 3, Becca Jordan.
Great, thanks, Lily. We're going to take one more quick break for National Anthem. Keep watching. You're currently watching the Denison Sports Network. Thank you. And welcome back to Denison Sports Network. I'm Nick Morton, joined alongside Lily Greenhead. The National Anthem has played. They seem to have their final pep talks by their coaches, and the teams are off and ready to go as they come off this first drive. Lily, what are you looking for right here?
Yeah, this is going to be a great matchup. Hopefully, both teams are going to come out ready to go. First drive, free throw, like I always say, and looking forward to a great game.
Great. Both teams are out still, to say the only way to play ahead of right now as they're ready to go off the last final pep talks and communication and defensive teams, I'm sure we're talking about right now, and making sure they're ready for this one. Second conference game for the Big Red, third for the Oberlin Yale women. Big Red posting a 1-0 record in NCAC, while Oberlin posting a 2-0 record. This game crucial for both as they're trying to keep their undefeated streak alive in conference play. Excuse me. One of them will walk away with a loss though, because that's how sports work. Both teams can't win. So they take off the draw, looks like the Big Red are going to have number 6 for Ledwell. Just waiting for the referee. And on the left. Looking for the clean sweep, not going to work. The Yale women are going to get that one. to start running down the field. We're going to take that behind. It looks like on the 32 first, Barlow is going to take it behind the goal. Kind of follow the left side of the set. Pass that up to the second up there. The ball's on the ground. She's all by herself, so number four in the carry, Pete Rosier, made a 6-8 one up. That's fine. This is the AMA just looking and stuff the offense. Oh, looks like number 32 Barlow is going to dodge. She's going to pass the middle of the field. We're going to get a foul off. There's going to be five against the Big Red. Going to give the Yeoman in the first three position opportunity of the game. It's 29-19 left. Get into the whistle. Alright. She's going to shoot. That's a great stop by Becky Jones. She's going to end up outside of the goal looking to clear herself. Ball's on the ground. Right at the net. We're going to see what happens here. Yeoman in front of the attack. Becky Jones over the back and goal. That's great defense there. And great awareness by the Big Red. And it's wide open. Yeoman on the side of GLE, so wasn't able to grab it there. And the side of GLE, and that's going to be a Big Red wide they're looking for. And the side of the South, there's a question. Going to force Peter Berger to pick that one up. He's going to pass it up to Nick Berger and number 10 take. And we're just going to round it inside of the offense. No reason left. A bit of a dive there. Not too much there, so he's going to push it back out and work around. Peter Berger with it. He looks at the feet. Crossing the double there, we're going to keep going. He's going to pass that back out from the 33. Barrow's going to take it in. So that's going to be five against the Big Red. Barrow's going to line up in the right eye on the 6-meter mark. Pass that into the middle space. Beautiful pass. Great job. That's going to be a high low finish for the goal.
That was a great looking finish. For the Big Red, MSN both schools and had 2,000 turnovers by Oberlin, so they definitely need to make sure that they were Oberlin can make push passes and create open space and so they're not giving up the ball so quickly.
Exactly. So, going to have a one-way deficit here for Big Red. It's 28-17 left to play. Not a huge deficit, as they were down 3-0 against that region this past Wednesday. They're able to come back and even take a 2-goal lead at some different times of the game. And 1-0 really isn't anything terrible to worry about. Not at all, so we're going to get another draw here. Looking for possession, and that's really further from the fast round. It's all about possession. There's the referee, he's going to be strong. They're setting for the ball right now. Number 5. He's going to go Big Red away. He's going to 6K Lillard. He's going to pick that one up. He's going to flex right back. He's taking it down. We need an in and out of traffic through the defenders. Might be able to go to an angle there. He wants to pick that out. He's going to go back across the way to face himself. He's going to shoot, and he's going to pick that one in the back of the net right there.
Yeah, I kind of believe this quick try is really all the way down, and it's probably open spaces where they took it. Great shot up top.
Great shot it was. There's 27:52 left. And that's going to be a 1-1 game now, I think, not of us. Great play by Ledlow just to take a straight down. Looks like he's going to take the time, and he came right across the end. Put the defense a little bit with that slow start, and just keep going. This is very quickly. So, a little over 2 minutes played in this one, so this could be a very high score for the starting game. Going to be able to draw one more time. With last on here. Lovely to pick that up pretty soon. Looks pretty similar to just leave him in and out, but not too much, which means she's going to settle this one. No reason to push anything. She did not have the numbers she wanted. Ball's on the ground. She's going to keep that up pretty easily. Pass around the midfield. She's going to make a second healthy. She's looking at that. Five again. She's going to pass that back to 11 and Allen. Allen with a bit of a face on a spin. Didn't pull her defender if she wants to pass that one back. Nice cut in the middle. Great defense there to keep that ball from going out of his stick. And there's going to be a foul. So stick with the Big Red. great cut right there, however, though. Going to be looking for his all day. He's going to be taking away from the last 6 points. I love an eye on this. Looking for a cutter. A good job. He likes it. Tries again to his 60 David. Going to dish real quick. He's getting enough open. That can be a great save with a 1-on-1 shot by the goalie. And what info will add it.
Yeah, that way you get to go like a big red did a great job with some on-the-side movement. So it does, you know, good job picking up the ball and moving across to give way for it. Nice try to 1v1 and then even that didn't work. He's able to pass it off and play a red ball. So great work right there.
Here's going to be the first stage of this opportunity for the big red. That's going to be number 6 red ball. And he's going to pick up the top right and score.
So I'm going to knock it off the floor. They eventually got him in.
And that's all that matters. That's going to give the big red their first lead of the day in 2-1. It's way off free position. That's going to give them a 1-1, 100% in free position. Cannon's first percent is much better than that. 26 left to play in the first half. It's going to be a 2-1 big red advantage. The Yo women just going to set the defensive header. Try to have some passive communication changes and the defensive breakdown they have right there. Up for the blow. With the blow just in the air, looking for a clean sweep. Maybe he's going to be able to get that one. Still in the ball, they're fighting. Yo Yo will pick it up. There's a foul. Going to give Yo Yo away anyway. Looking to Jay, that's going to be number 21 Mike here with it. He's going to pass that one back. Maybe he's going to be kind of weaving him out. He's going to take his first ball going to go. And yet another whistle. Going to go against the big red. Doing Barlow. Her first three position opportunities again. It's going to be a shot, not going to be a score. Big shot there for the Yale women. Three position, looks like the same one that Red Lakers had, but she went low.
Yeah, I see him before, like, taking him right there, and I think they call it up that they were close, they were able to get the three positions on it, but all of those three players games could break their opportunities.
Exactly, and it's 25-59. The score is netted up at 2. We're going to come back up for a draw. And it's 6 Red Lake, going to take it for Big Red once again, she has been for most of the season, she has been all day here. Like for replacing the ball. All right, once more. It's going to be a pretty clean sweep for Ludlow. He's going to take that down himself. He's going to walk the ball there with one hand on the stick. I think that's taking it himself, but the angle wasn't there. He's going to have to take it behind the other. Beautiful cut right there, and that's going to be a goal for number 7, Reed Hersey.
That was a great look right there. Running fast, straight back in the middle, and it's quick to get right into the goal.
Beautiful cut, beautiful finish, and that's going to be the big red. A 2-2 lead with 25-41 left to play in the first half. So far, we've seen a lot of scoring. 5 goals in less than 5 minutes. So defensively, hasn't really been anybody's goal.
No, not yet. I'd say the best teams are either starting on the communication, the passes, maybe looking at the low scoring game for themselves, tight matchup, defensively, really important.
I'm going to say there's any defensive adjustments that both students are going to make here. They both should have at least 2 goals in 5 minutes. Maybe see if the offense is that good. And that could be a very clean draw control there for Big Red. They're going to take it down right now. So we're going to see how he works. Going to pass that back up. Midfielder. They're going to take it to take it the whole way across. Just put him in. Nice stop there. There is a whistle. Waiting for the play. Not exactly sure what that was. It appeared to be shooting first, but.
Probably maybe 3 seconds or so.
Okay.
Some of them are kind of
nice cut there by the Big Red. It's coming off spinning five. Even better save by Lancelotta. Living with Fred Burke there. Lancelotta with it. And pass back to one of her defenders. She's looking good for two guys on the 17th goal there, I think. It was 21 in Maxfield. High pass, able to deflect off the Big Red stick and fire burn, but then that hurt and sticks to heavy yellow women. A bit of a slow break here, don't think I want to push it. She's looking good. Ball's been on the ground, that's going to be a great defense player by number 5, number 25, excuse me, and Murray for Big Red. Going to push against the yellow women, so that's going to be a Big Red way. Quick pass there, they're looking past it, looks so good. That's up to number 6, Ludlow, she's coming up down. This is over number 11, Allen. Allen quickly over. That's going to be a shot. That's going to be another great save by Allen's
Allen. That was a great transition on the bench for a Big Red, but I really came down the field and looking to kick a little down the field.
It was number 11, Allen with it. She's going to just save it to the left Allen. Look at being across the middle. Even her way in the traffic. This is a team chase drive, so if I can just see this one, team level. I'm going to see how he works with it.
Number 8
is Harrison. Excuse me. Jersey's a good touch game. They're going that one on the Monday. Not my player, so. Number 8 has been the shot. Downer. Another great save by Lancelot, and he's going to be a step clear once again. Looking close. Big Red really able to set up a ride here. Number 26 to Garrett with it. Pass that up to Mitchell. That's over number 21 in Maxfield. Mitchell's going to put that down. Bit high, way over the head of her player. And that's going to roll out of bounds. Definitely took a time on that last touch of free throw. Ball is going to go a big way. Big way as well. And number 15, Jim Gibbs, three passing away with her over the center. And then Marley bringing it up to set. And over to Kabula. We're really looking to move it, which she does. Now it's going to see how he walks with it. She puts his hands on this side of the arm. One half tip around the way of maintaining possession. Over and six in the air, trying to block the pass this evening. She's going to work around the left side. Looking for the cutters because they've had lots of practice. Success earlier today. I'm simply looking to feed here, but didn't have much luck with those sticks up in the air like that. She's looking perfect, she's in a roll, quickly cross off. Looking for a dish. Pass is there, really had to stretch the needle, wasn't able to get to work. Gonna be a foul. That's gonna be a yellow card. Going against the other yellow one, and number 7, Hannah Hinkie Green. She's going to take her time with some burn of this. 22-21 left, the Big Red lead 3-2.
Yeah, I was trying to switch from the way that I was hard to get. Most people were looking at second in the head, so I was trying to find what the color was.
So it looks like I'm going to speak to this opportunity here. Over there to 6 meters, she's going to go in, 3 and 2. That's going to be a high, high shot, 4 goals. Great shot there for the 3 position, and that's going to be 2-2 for the Big Red in the first position so far today. Something that is definitely going to help them score the first position, as I said, a free opportunity. Crazy how that works.
The Big Red, although they've scored off on 3 positions so far, have a very kind of composure on them. They've got a lot of different tips and cutters down the middle. They're both going to have a space for the 1v1. So hopefully we'll see some goals on some of them in the future.
And I think the young women started to realize that they had a stick up in the air and they were really playing a little bit more aggressively and they're not trying to keep the cutters off, but SR defense is a lot better in that last possession. So I think that's really what they're going to try to do right here. Off the ball, it's going to be a great pickup for the Big Red. They're going to bring it down, so they're going to take a selfie. They're going to take that stretch on the left side as they lead 4-2 as we approach 22 minutes left. They're going to blow past her defender. It's going to be another foul. I That's going to be final number 6 against Adrian College. Hopefully, with her opportunity to see position, she's going to come off. Looking to shoot, if she can, she does. And another save by Ancelotta. Butterfly. And we've been announced. Probably been attempting to get the intercept tonight. Wasn't able to get it. Adrian with a break. They're going to shoot. They're going to save. Going to stick with the yellow one for possession. They're going to step away for settled offense. As we say, 21 minutes. They can move this one around here on the right eye. And 21 left here. Can I stop that behind the pole? So we see Barlow looking for something with it. A lot of active off-ball movement by Adrian College. Great question there for Big Red is not doing good speed. Number 5 and 6 possession of the Adrian winner. And see that a little bit taller there, which he does.
This is one of the top leaders and top challenges this season, so that was a great understanding that we had.
I think so far, so, you know, doing so much different from high school to college, but obviously she's going to figure it out and probably turn over. It's going to be a shot by Yelena. Russian's going to break the big red, the backup wasn't there. We're going to move it to one half it. I was going to be fighting for the ball. Number 5 against the Yale women. That's going to be the big red well. And then number 23, the boy, is going to fight with it. He's going to throw past her defender. He's going to keep moving until somebody spots her. Taking a pass, which he does. And just got up to the midfield and number 2 well. Well, it's going to be going to start. He's going to be in the left alley. Taking a few defense to study it. Bring that back across the middle. They can set the offense into the cut. Behind the goal. Great cut there. That's going to be a shot. That's going to be another save for Lauren Delia. That's going to be her 6th. That's number 17 in Derek. On the other end, too. Looks like he's been running about 5 defenders. He's going to pass that one out to first just face that. And again, that's passed up by guys number 21, Maxfield. Team makes offense before. Maxfield going to pass that over to number 33, Barlow. He's going to work from behind because he's going to cut his finger open. Going to be big job, great defense there. Going to be shot, great play by number 2, Becky Jameson goal. A bit under 18 defenders. Going to be number 25, Emily Marlott. She is all by herself. She's just going to keep going until somebody attempts to stop her. Going to get that over to number 6, Trey Ludlow instead. Looks like a solid offense. With 16, it's mostly going to take that in herself. Still looking to move. Ball's going on the side of the stick. He's going to get that ground ball, work it back out. Maybe even a 6-4-9. Turn the two walls. Going to pass it over to 19 and over. Big deal just waiting. Put that over to 6 and Redlow. Going to pass that over. Going to work it behind the goal right now. Just passing around, looking for a cut. And not too aggressive for the cut. There's no reason to believe we're under 17.5 plus. And that's an easier living for the crowd. Nice cut right off of that. Great cross by Yeager in defense. So they pass the line. Call it same play once more. Didn't like it. That's going to be a push against the Yeager winner. It's going to be a big red. She's going to line up. For her three positions. And that might be six good receiver. Not a great angle, but she's there. Waiting for the whistle. A little bit too far out. Two more pushes. Lance is going to push it again by herself. She's going to go in. Another save by Lance Lada. That's going to be number seven. She's having her stuff done.
That was great defense right there by the great red guy. They were looking in the mud. They had Allen and Tarleton in the middle and trying to cut off each other. And then Holly Westbrook, great job trying to do a bunch of cut with them.
Your women on the floor, they're looking to move it. Ball's going to be on the ground and maintain possession. Denison looking to press over harder on the ride. It isn't going to work because your women can move it, take that one down. They're already in the offensive zone of only 16.5 plus. Going to bring that over to about middle of it. Number four, Peter Briggs going to bring that back over. Going to switch fields. Just passing. That looks like there's a head of steam here. It wasn't so bad. Didn't like it. Tom Drake is going to pass that back. Looking for some press. Haven't been as active on this direction as they have been before. But we're going to become Drake one point. We're going to move, we're going to go down the right aisle. Not able to get it. She's going to have another 20 run with. There's a lot of receiver. She's on the ground, slow to get up. That's his overkill. It's a great to see. Another one seeing injury. We're here at 15:36. Down some big red leading 42. It's going to be a clear opportunity for the big red. See if they can do it this time. Good look there, going to be able to get back to number 15, good speed. Quick work to Newberry, number 2, Walsh. Walsh taking his strike. Pass that down to 11 Allen. She has a seam, she's going to go. Across the middle. Great cross there by the other in defense. Not able to get that one in. That's going to be a bit of a high pass. Try to save it, which she does. No back of there, that's going to go over in Callum's way. Very quick clear there. And the 21 mock field. And where's that down the middle? She goes by a defender. She's taking her time, doesn't have numbers. But she's going to push through, try to get something out of it. Very good defense there, body position adjustment. She's going to get flashed on, she's going to force that one back out, looking to move it. She does. And it's 32 better way behind the goal, if you've seen her there all day. I'll take it to the start, pushing some cutters, maybe some more dives behind the start. The fast DLA thought about it, going to go back behind the goal, punch it off. Nice little move there, and that's going to go in for the other one. There's going to be a 4-3 jump in here, 14-15 left across.
That was a great use of the two center guns and then sent one way and then drive and defend it and then quickly switch back the other way and get into the inside of the goal. So that was a great move right there. Classic one of the two.
Classic one of the two it was. That's going to make this game 4-3 with 14-15 left. So in the first 5 minutes, we saw 5 goals. Since then, we've seen 2 in the past 10. So obviously, the defense has settled down. Really liking what they've done so far. Been a lot of offensive possessions for the big red, so you have to give credit to Yeager and Yeager women for only giving up one goal there in the past 10 minutes.
Well, you have to really give that to that one for Adder. She's been doing a great job with the series by 10 minutes.
And we're going to get for a draw once more. 14-15 left to play. And the American is violation. I can go over and away. She drives it by her defender. She's going to keep getting down. Let's take a look on the radar yourself. It's coming in at 33 Barra. Always busy. It's going to be high. Luckily, there's another young woman right behind her, so we know it's high. Looks like a pretty pass for the other offender there. And it's going to break with it. A lot of passing up around the midfield play. Something we haven't seen from the Oberlin yet is they like to play a lot from behind the goal. So Peter Bay going to get behind the goal now. This is what we're used to seeing from them. We can move it, they're just moving around in a pretty counterclockwise formation. Just not really looking to push. I think it's worth a defense there by number 25 and Mario for the big red. Same person just on my first left. Nice little cut there. Somebody shot. Things are wide left. And 52 are winning the backup. They're not winning 13 minutes before the next first half. Ball's going up on the ground. Oberlin able to keep it. 24 feet away. Making a move. Things are below another 22 in Rocker. We're going to move it. Let me turn Drake with it. Get that over the head player in 4 and 2 of those. Bit of a roll method of the guys. And just kind of a fancy. Even one of them is nice race. Let's take this on the right out of yourself. Let's move. Which he does. Got a full head of teammates on the 32 Barlow. Barlow looking to dish it. Nobody in for the cut in the middle. Quickly gets doubled. Then straight rid of it. Barlow once again. Because they've got some receiving space to fire against the big red.
We've been doing a great job right now in the atmosphere, really communicating. And the number one is sitting on the lane today, there's always two people there. Right?
Yeah. And it's three because we've had two minutes for the year running. Take this one in. That's in this area, another this area. That's in the two saves from number 30, excuse me, number 3 bucket games, not number 33. And there's 33 Barlow is the one with the ball there. A lot of threes out there. We're 9 and 5, so Oberlin can keep it. We're going to move number 7. Kind of a green looking kick. They'll take it behind the goal instead of throwing his back off on number 15 in Dixford. They'll play from 11-20 left to play in the first half. Big red lead, 4-3. Oberlin on the attack. Oberlin is going to put a great off-ball defense there for the big red. Another 33 Barlow with a great shot. Almost putting that top right corner. Great save by Bucket James to keep it out. That's going to be a foul against big red.
Yeah,
it's
the
Oberlin having
to move out of
the
other
side to the other side and clear the lane for the lane to go in. Number 3 just had a few moves to the other one. He's got on the face of the right type here. He's going to take it, that's going to be a spot. Great save by number 3, Bucket James. That's that stick down, which is going to raise it, it's flopped out and before it made it any farther. We're under 11, of course. On the clear, it's going to be number 2, he's still moving. I'd say he's broken at this point. He's got some speed. They pass out right in the middle of number 7, Hershey. Thought about the shot, wasn't there. There's no recovery. He's looking to score. Another save by Lyle Pilata. He is lights out. That ball has to be the size of a beach ball for her right now. He has seen everything. He's seriously over with her here as they're looking to get this one as another successful one. As they are currently 3-4. Make that 4-5. They have a nice 80% on the day. That's going to be top. That's going to be a 4 for the Oberlin Yale winning.
That is a great way to win. They certainly have a great structure. They have a 40% ace rating throughout there. So, we're going to get a lot of them.
Number 32, Grace Barlow with the goal. That's going to matter. That's up 4 with 10-13 left to play in the first half.
I think you guys are
good. It looks like it. all I'm asking is not for a game like on Wednesday for the Big Red. If they drop that one by one, because that was a little tough to deal with. My heart was racing for a little bit too long there. You know, got to say that's not good, but that's just too high for me.
It's great though,
so can't complain. I'll take back game any day as long as, you know, they can get another quarter than that. It's played great games. I think it's a great last non-conference game for the Big Red. It's now they're fully in the conference play. And the best game they've played all year, so it'd be good momentum to take in the conference play as they're going to try to get into the tournament. That's why it's going to go off our stand again. Finally picked up by an Oberlin play. I'm going to quickly get it. I love first speed. He's going to try to blow through. There's a triple team right there, and another triple team. He's going to finally get the man as there has to be one on the triple team. Ball's going to go a little bit wide. Jay wouldn't be able to save it, however. They can move it, have a 4-2 to go with it. Working behind it now, maybe he's a special. Put a wide pass, he's able to fly ahead of it. Hunter Jr. trying to go in, wasn't there. Hunter Jr. excuse me, he is a junior. He's going to be a great spot up to stop the bucket of James. And they can be a foul. Two last chance here for the Big Red. So I pass that quickly over number 25 Mario, and bucket of James is not the one that wants to take it up herself. While it still wasn't around, she's going to lay the ground in case she can find an open man. Still looking, she finally found one in number 8 Pelican. There's going to be the ground, she's by herself, so hopefully she can be able to get that one. They come behind the goal right now. Allen with it. Allen looking for the cutter. A couple cutters from up top, nothing too major there. Looks like there's another two in work. Pass that up to the middle, he's going to try to dive up top. Israel with it, he thinks about it. Rolls back, he makes it to fall. Pass Allen, put it across to Allen. Allen's going up on the ground. So you have to pass that.
Holy shit.
So it says that one, VK takes this team in this one. They're going to move it to Greg. We're behind the goal right now. Maybe he's a push. Try to force forward to the coach, 8 minutes. He's going to get the best shot they can. As Frankie Waddle has been raked out so far. Logan Allen, she's thinking about that one. He's going to roll a bunch of circles. He's going to end up on the ground. That's going to be a foul against the other and the other one. Number 11, Allen. She's going to take that right directly in the middle of the goal for her free position. She's taking that three in which she does. And what is it? Another save by Lion Flyer. That's going to be number 7.
Big Red doesn't have to work on taking Lion Flyer if they're going to have to work on it. So you take how she goes, hitting the opposite, but work on coming in the goal around her.
Then now she's a quick wall, and there's nothing getting past her. Number 4, Peterborough gets a move, which he does. That's going to be another successful career. That's going to be 5-6. Great check there by Big Red defense. It's going to be a foul, however. A little bit too aggressive on that one. That's fast. He's going to start starting. He's going to pass that back up to the midfielder. Coming in with 33 ball, they're going to take it back around the goal. They drop them in, putting them back there. She's going to go low to low. That's going to be a shot, that's going to be a score.
I think just wide open like that, it's not right on him, and that's certainly a score.
A very pretty goal there for the young woman.
They can just have to keep their communication up, and also just keep them specific so they can either try to back on any chances in the air, or
and that's going to be number 21, Marissa Maxfield. She's going to put that one in. That's going to be her first goal of the day. going to give them a 5-4 advantage with 6:47 left to play in the first half. I'll come up with another draw, number 6, Ludlow. Two back and forth games, so if you've seen this one before. Pretty entertaining, though. Can't complain about that. As much as I love the win for the 17-2, I can't see every now and then a very competitive game. So we clean off the draw to number 25, Hayden Jackson. Yeah, we're going to make a choice. That's going to be a foul. It's going to be a push against the big red, number 32, Chris Barrio. Looks like that one. He had a cut right in the middle. Wasn't able to see it, though. Just didn't want to pass out. It's the fifth for the left. Looking to move with the guys. Excuse me, let's say Barrio's getting the first play. Going to lay that behind the goal as we approach 6 minutes. Come off from the left alley. That's a nice little face back right there. She's gonna work by.
Exactly.
So we're going to foul here for the big red, so that's gonna give them a free position opportunity, but that's no underway right there, so she either just work it around or bring it back. She's gonna work around instead. Good across the way. Great flash by the big red, so she's gonna be forced back behind the goal. So they're gonna try that from up top this time. All that faith in the diving, then she tries again, tries against it once more. Nice cut in the middle by number 20. Going from the ground, right behind him. There's number 4, and two big. There's going to be fast. He had a lane too, so he could have done something with it right there. He's really fine behind him.
Yeah, he's really just on top now, and he's like the ground time. He's right there in the ball, and then he quickly switched to the shooting space.
Number 4, Peabody, with her opportunity here. Waiting for the whistle. She gets it. Looking to shoot. That's going to be a great stop by number 3, Becca Jones. Away from her stick, but she's able to bring that one over. Get the save. Looking to clear. That's going to be the first unsuccessful clear for the big red today. They've been great on them so far. Try to save that meter in the middle, but there were 4 big red defenders there. Ball's always both over to Russell Blue with a push against Big Red on number 8, Lizzie Pelican. She's another 6 player level. And a good game as well. And the 43 ball is going to pass that in. And work this one from the top, looks like for the other side. And the 3 guys right there. They can pass that one back. It's going to be a foul in against the big red. Going to stick with the yellow in over the 4:25 left to play. Oberlin leading 5-4. And that's going to be shot, that's going to be a score for the yellow win, and that's going to give them a 6-4 lead. Pretty shot off the free position right there. Not much you can do there.
That's all about the count, so it doesn't have to keep coming down, and you have to get your stick to be able to just like it one way or another. They just trying to get your ball out there, so sometimes it's really difficult, but they can wait with this.
Going to see what they can do here is the big red face a 2-goal deficit with 4:22 left to play. They're going to talk to the draw. Really, I don't want to put words in your mouth here, but do the big red need to get possession?
You know what, Mike? I'm pretty sure the big red needs possession. Possession is the name of the game.
I've heard that once or twice before. Can't even get t-shirts made because possession is the name of the game.
What is this draw? This is the game.
It's going to be a great draw. So the listeners would buy into that trade. She's really going to get it up far. They're looking for number 11, Allen, with it. She's going to figure out the left alley herself. Might be able to push it. She didn't have numbers. Also, pass over another switch. Ludlow. followed by that extravaganza. That's number five. It's a big red. So we're going to hit the three to this opportunity from the white post. She's looking to shoot. Could be a deflection. Possibly have a pipe or a third. There are a lot of defenders in the way. So instead of shooting the goalie, they're shooting to me. So it's going to work just as well. Rotation 330 left to play. Over and leading 6-4. Looking good for the clear. Over and 6-7 stays on the guy. Looking to make it 7-8. Didn't like the idea. There's going to be a foul against the big red, so we're going to move that one back. Number 10 is Dave, so we're going to take that from the 12 meter. We'll move that one in. Still working around. 240 up to play. No reason why it's going to be this. Nice cut in the middle. Wasn't able to maintain it as the passing was high. Then up in the 600 feet, Bucket James in goal. Going to pass that over to number 23, Gavula. Excuse me, number 25, Mollet. She was looking for Gavula. 46 and a half miles from number 23, Gavula. Great ride there by the other one. Looking at clear. Looks like clear. Gonna bring that down the offensive line. We're 2 minutes left to play in the first half. Going to make right down by two. Now the snow is starting to come down. I'm very happy to say that I'm inside the first half because that does not look like fun. Nothing like it. You know, I thought it was spring. Could be wrong. That's going to go for over in college. Although it's a high pass, that's going to be an unforced turnover in the big red. We're at 140 left to play. They're going to look clear. Get that in the middle. Walsh on the red. They force that back. They're looking to get that to their goalkeeper. Looking to clear. Get that over number 17, Derek. Number 5, Jackson, the freshman midfielder. He's got some speed. Pass it up, that looks like it's going to be another successful clear. Ball's on the ground. It's going to be blocked against the big red. It's going to stay with the yellow one. That's going to be another successful clear. It's going to be clear number 8 out of 9 for the yellow one. So, first time is great. Can I ask you much better than that? I'm going to say 9 for 9, but you know, that's the same way at this point. 50 seconds to play. They're going to go straight around the left alley, see what they can do with it here. Looking to push. Going to be quickly cross line. Nice little cut. And 25 miles, looking to kick that one up. Even just that in the stick of the midfield. It will take 35 seconds to play. They're working it down. There's a break. And they tell him, what they see on the leg they didn't see. They cross that over. Going to weave in and out. That's going to be a foul. Going to give the big red a free to this opportunity. Is the number 19, Leah Israel, with her first free throw opportunity for the day. She had 24.5 seconds to play to be exact. With the blaze, she's going to go in. That's going to be a high and high shot. That's going to be a shot. That's going to be a goal.
That's going to be a great work right there by the big red eyes. They quickly tried to move it down and get a goal to make it a run. Go differently. So, right before they went in on halftime.
Great way to go in halftime like that. There's definitely momentum there. It's going to give the big red a 6-5 deficit with 21.4 seconds left to play. Really big goal, especially after this team like the yellow one. We're going to get the last shot, possibly run the clock out in the offensive zone. But we got a really quick clear and transition and just position to make it work.
And with the fast pace game like the qualifier, you really want to grab this time and do this again. So, maybe hopefully we'll come to halftime with a tie game.
That would be crazy, so weird. I think it's crazy, it's kind of like it. Off the draw, looking for the clean play. After the clean two for the big draw, they're going to look to move it. And the fifth red light is there, facing 12 seconds. They're looking to score, they're going to move a little bit faster than that. Let me see Walsh with it, we're down to 7. Down to 5, she sees the clock, doesn't think she's going to need to do much with it. 3 seconds to play, they're going to need to shoot now. And it's not going to happen, the tie of players in the big red. Not too bad though, is they're going to get that quick goal at the end and make it 6-5 going in halftime.
Definitely some great moments that you saw in the half.
You can see right there, they even had another opportunity there, so something to build off of for one goal exit. Regardless, we're going to take a 10-minute break here. Thanks for watching Denison Sports Network. I'm Nick Horton, from alongside Lady Greenhead. Don't go anywhere. And welcome back to Denison Sports Network. My name is Nick Horton, I'm joined alongside Lady Greenhead. As halftime is over, both teams are coming out. Oberlin leading 6-5. Look at the stats. Almost all of them are identical. Three is draw controls. Three position goals, three position opportunities. Fouls, nearly everything identical. The only thing that stands out is number 32, the game for Oberlin, electrolyte into water, with 10 saves already. Big first half. Really, what do the big reds need to do in order to get the most top-end goals and to have those scores?
Well, even though they scored in the 6-5, the big reds were coming out really, really good, coming out well. Maybe from the first half, and then start to go to the lead. And to do this, they're going to have to, they didn't wake up with the fires and the patience, but they're going to have to work around the 6 to go and maybe do some more points.
Very thank you. I would like to say there's been a goalie training for the big red, as they usually is at halftime. It's going to be number 33. Tanner McGarrigan, the freshman, is going to come in for the big red. And just like that, off of the foul, the big red to the right down, had a shot. And once again, right off the ladder with the save, giving his save number 11. So the Yale women looking for a clear here. 8-9 on the day, trying to get 9-10, which would be a nice 90%. Yes, that can be division by 10, that's about it. Should be the flex. That's going to end up in the 633 Barlow. She's going to take it down. She's looking for first. She's going to be pushed right out. She has no angle. She's going to be forced to take that behind the goal. And before Peterberg was going to move it. Put that over another 10 goals in the top. So from the 6th field here. Put him to the back of the middle possible.
Some great defense
right there,
down in the 19
and 18. Phenomenal defense, actually. That's going to be the first turnover. Falls in on the ground once again. Minnesota's going to go off on the yellow ribbon. The referee agrees with me. That's good to see. Because usually I don't agree with the referee. As an athlete, you tend to never do. We're taking 28.5 minutes here. And we're looking for the big red to continue the phenomenal clearing today is they are 9-9 for 100%, something that you rarely ever see by any team. Big Red also averaging about 76% clears on the year, so 100% is a big thing for them. They're going to look to cut in after that ball ended up on the ground, and that's where it's back out there.
Yeah,
that's
where the number 2 had a lot of time with the ball on the ground, but they really took it right on top.
To continue that phenomenal match here, that's going to be 10% on 2, give them 100%. We're going to break that back behind the goal now. Let's move it around, trying to stop that right now. Number 19 is Israel with it. Over the number 7, Percy. She's looking to make her move. 5 against it, just going to pass that back behind the goal instead. Still moving in the same direction. Israel thought about the guys, fouled against it. Cut in the middle, ball's going up on the ground, that's going to be a foul against the yellow, and that's going to keep with the big red. We are 27-24 left to play in the second half.
Yeah, like there's a big red trying to load the right side of the field and play it in the kind of a front side down, and you had a great one to go, but just kind of finding my three positions.
My three positions, and she's going to push that in the back of the net. That's going to tie this game up at 6-6 with 27-21 left to play. Big day right there. They're continuing that momentum they had at halftime. So I think they're pretty happy with what they're doing. That's going to be a six-played leg way. That's going to be her fourth goal of the day on the big day. She had 5 wins against that evening, so she's on a pretty nice stretch right now.
I'd say that.
9 goals in 2 games, and this one's not even over yet, so got a good start with the her. Don't have any draw control right now. We'll line up on the same side here, waiting for the rest of the league. There's the whistle, ball's in the air, looks like they're going to clean jump. Ridley's going to get that clean. We're 5 instead of 21 with the match here for the young women. And there's the big red, there's that set start right there. Something that's new going to start this year.
Yes, it is. Really shooting up the game right there.
It is, it's pretty exciting stuff. And the 19-year-old Israel is looking to move on himself. We'll get that over to number 7 in Hershey. I'll take that down the right alley, look for the players, didn't see it, don't get that behind the goal instead. Is the big red usually likes to take a couple seconds of the offensive possession from behind the goal, which is like a just some cutter smart top. See that top instead, and then the back and took a 50 already. Doesn't work around. See if the yellow they're going to give on him. Looks like they're making sure they're going to play. And they are, there's going to be some cuts, which they're going to try to cut off of each other in the middle. Might not be even be an ISO for number 19 Israel. Can be a nice cut down the middle. Put on their defense there to push it back out. Israel is going to take the game, that's going to be fast. I'm not sure if he's shooting too much.
I'm not sure they're going to be shooting too much. There's two players standing in the middle, and they're going to go out through there and attempt to save them to come.
We have 26-05 left to play in the second half here. Leah Israel is pushing to this opportunity. And that's going to be a little quick.
There's a fight that was going to right before the whistle, and now we have a clean of possession.
That's a big foul right there. It's going to finish off an entirely free position, which is a great opportunity for the big red. But instead, we're going to go in today. We're going to take it down. We're going to keep on moving. No one's going to stop us, so why not? Finally stop, face the pressure, she's going to pass that out. Number 33, Bowler with the main name here for the Yale women. Tom Jake up in the middle of the field. Looks like she might try her hand on the job. Looking for it. She said, not going to fool there, they're going to pass that back out to 33, Bowler. Let's put the field here. And then it looks like the middle one's taking back. The 5 Watson taking her hand at it. Ball's going up on the ground. They're going to clearly get that one. And the 10 Drake with him move. Comes over to number 4 in Peterberg. And the one that's going to be a foul with their shooting space. So we'll get her a free for this opportunity. She's going to line up over here by the left post. She's going to go in, she's going to shoot, and she's going to score to give the young women their lead back at 7-6.
That was really cute, really, really cool. I'm just like taking a little bit of a sideline shot and a lot of speed on it. So, now we're up at 7-6.
Let's see, oh, still a tight game. So, that's going to be number 4 in the Taylor Peterborough. It's going to be her first goal of the day. Also her first point. So it's 24-59. The Yale women are going to lead this one 7-6. Still anybody's game. It's been a good one so far. See if any team can go on a run here. Doesn't seem like it's going to happen as all of these stats are nearly identical. The both teams have been playing extremely hard, extremely fast. Doesn't look like anybody's getting anything to move. Off the draw, another 2 Walsh going to get back to the big red. Going to take that on his back on the left alley. She's moving. She's got a really good speed right there.
That's a good speed right there.
I'm going to pass that over to Monty Mazur. Cut in the middle. Great pass there by number 11, Allen. Looks like they're going a little high, a little wide.
It's a good stick right there for Colin by Bowler. She's trying to cut through the middle.
Luckily, the backers are going to keep it, so Monty will come back all later. Long Island, and kind of played with 6th red list. That led to Israel. Israel down the road there. Simply just passing around on the mound, they left for a quick 24 minutes. And then passes over to Israel. Israel taking his job. He's going to go right down. Yet another save for Enchilada. That's going to be save number 12. Looking for clear. 10 for 11 on the goal for clear. Make that 10 for 12. Great ride there for the big red. Steady way to get it. Numbers weren't there, so he wants to set it back out and look for the set it off on the set limit for a break. As we approach 23 and a half to play. Opening up 7-6 on here against the big red. We've had over number 11 Allen behind the goal. Haven't been here back there for a little while, trying to see if he has anything to do with the player back there. Bouncing up on the ground. They're going to make the shoot if they get it. But for me, that's going to be a push. That's a big red. It's 23 minutes to play. They're looking clear. And pass that back. They will completely set their ride. Coming from midfield, we need to get there. It's a season where they take a stealth. Stealth in midfield. Looks like they're sticking out of 17 Garrett. Jordan, his placement behind the two walls, wasn't able to get it, however. So we see Barlow, he's a bit of a screen, he's going to pass, and he's another one. Just behind, as that ball's going to go in, that's going to be a score to make it 8-6 for the year win. Quick passing because he's very quick. Very from the student house is fine. That's crazy. The goal is going to be 8-6 to 22-30 left to play. Jordan is leading the big red. Big red is familiar, being down by a couple goals and able to come back. So nothing to worry about here. 22 minutes is a ton of time. They're going to get to the draw here. They're going to step on the same side of the line. See if this is anything. We've seen this a couple times today.
Well,
it just depends on
what
way that you want to take
the game,
or
you want to
kind of
either
from
the
front
one
way
or another.
Ball from behind the crown. Making a move, which is a big stem in there. Ball's starting to move out a little bit. Possibly to pick somebody, that's
going to make them to 611
iron.
So I think it's
going to
kind of,
as
it back out and then
takes the... Nice pass number 7, and number 2 Walsh. They can move in this civil offensive possession right here. Israel with it. Israel to get that over the command. Granville here, see if he can work that back behind the goal right now. Putting her hand up on this side. It's going to be a minor. You know, not quite about pinching the side again, so it's going to work that around with some cutters. There's one right there. She's able to roll back. I'm going to put that bounce right over the top pipe. I thought that one was going in. We made it make 7 during the front. Big red able to maintain possession, however. That's going to be number 17. But Jimmy Harris with the ball. She's looking to roll to sleep. She got flashed down. That's going to be a foul. She's going to get back. That's going to be her sleep. First sleep to this opportunity for the day. I'll take this from the left face. From the day. She's going to blow by her defender. She's going to get checked. Looks like in the knee, she went down pretty hard. She's able to get back up there. Good to see that happen. Taking her time and readjust her body there, but she's ready to go. She's going to take this in the middle now. Steady step. That's going to be a score right there for the freshman number 17, Virginia Hamilton. Take this an 8-7 game, a 21-14 left to play. Love to see that happen. As we're in 8-7 game with 21 minutes left to play. Going to come up to the ball once more. Number 6, Clay Ludlow. Going to take this one again against number 20, Natalie Walker. Same match as we've been seeing most of them. That's going to play the whistle. There's no timeout. So, pitch in a few real quick.
Can't let anyone
take him out, man. Yep, the serious fit, but it's good to see. Hopefully she's covered out of that one. Up to the draw. With the blows, balls in the air, looking for a clear one. Clean one, that is. And there's a dead ball in the ground. Go in there to pick it up. Pass that back. I'm looking to move it with two guys. He's going to go between two defenders. Get that over number 33, Barlow. Not really moving around right now. And this kind of looks like bubbles because it's not really going down.
Kind of like a snow game.
Exactly. That's just what it feels like to be in 5-1. So, pretty interesting show to use. Adrian's gonna pass around. He's only 20 and a half to play. 21 match here, they can move. Get that over to the right alley. Put that behind the goal. A lot of off-ball movement right now. Some cuts from up top and from side to side. They're starting to cut and kick off of each other. Great defense on another 7 here, so we keep her behind the goal. Still looking to move it around. Denison not giving up too much space right now. She's going to say to see Barlow trying to play. Has a bit of isolation. Maybe some cuts that she's going to look for. She might just be a feeder. She's going to go way out into the corner. Pass it over to number 22 in Walker. We'll show you see Barlow taking her hand out, then flip it back over to number 20. Looking to move. Slowly working around. And then roll it back into the same rocket. Walker in the defense. Not there, that's going to be number 20. Natalie Walker with the shot and the score to increase the lead to 9-7 with 19-13.
It looks like the three of them right there at times for last game, looking around really well at the defenders, and then passing around to take the guys by region, and then they ended up trying to force it over to the other side, but the rest of the team took two other side, really creating these gaps, and then using it to drive over there and get it in.
Great offense right there, that's an increase to lead back to 19-16 left to play. We're going to look for a draw right now. Really just great offense right there.
Yeah, it was a good play in this game. And so the big brothers should just keep up their communication, and they've been doing a great job on the better teams and the classes so far this year, and just got to keep that up.
Right here off the draw. Going to look for possession. Going to directly place the ball by the whistle. Ball plate, hand in the air, whistles off. Can be a violation against Oberlin. Trying to get with the big red, and it's too hairy and white with it. I'll take that down himself. Looking to start it. Take left, front right, straight to iron. Not thought about moving it in. Try to jump it and get that over the Ludlow. Ludlow's going right in the middle. She gets crashed by three defenders. Try that again. Just got over. Ball on the ground. Number 7 is going to have a chance to get around that. Got a few walls with it. It's a few things like six and field. Pass that over. Ball on the ground. That's going to be a trap. Really a trap. Against the yellow one. Can stick with a big red. Number 11, Allen with her chance. first again. Nice cut there by Harry Walsh. That's going to be another save by Lance Lauder. That's going to be lucky save number 13. 18-15 left to play. Looking for the clear. Move that up. Don't try to get the wide for that. Really reflected though.
I didn't have a lot of opportunities to make sure that I can 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 make sure that I
from an illegal truck from Denison. Adrian's going to line up closely to this opportunity here. Looking to bring it in. Looking for the hill cutter. He's going to pass that back behind. It's going to be another try against the big red. For the spot number 19. Three for this opportunity. He's going to take it in. He's going to take it in. He's going to shoot. He's going to go wide left. Back up there. Now he's going to go out of bounds. He's able to maintain the possession. Nice put there in the middle. Even better defense to keep it out of the scoring chance. Yet another foul. Going to give them another three for this opportunity. That's going to be number 21. Was just a match good. Waiting for the whistle, she goes. Looks like that's going to be a false start.
Yeah, that's a false start.
Going to go to Big Red's way. It's a 17 away left play. Big Red down by two. That's just out of stuff. She's taken. She does kill, so. Like that. Ended up with a stick of number 9 right here. Falls on the ground. Frank's water going in by 4 hitting goal. Looking for a clear. Defender going to blow past her. Mona will go up. Ball's on the ground. This can be a fight this round, though. And it's 21 Mike Green able to get the ground ball, but she gets kicked and she goes down hard.
So we're not going to let it go again. There's 50-50 balls over there in the middle now. Possession is key.
Possession is key. Possession is the name of the game. Yeah. Mike Green got it. She's going to pass that down to Allen. There's a bit of a break here. Then we jump there. She's going to take a step back. She's going to pass around to set it off on. She's going to have a 6 blood race. She's going to dish that over. Another 21 Mike Green. Mike Green's going to get student space caught against the catch for her. And we'll hit 3 for this one, too. We'll hit 16-01 left play. Going some big red down. 9-7. Line of first for the left post here. He's going to go in. Finish up the shot. Quickly flash off. We're going to back that one back out.
That was a great decision. We're going to try and take the shot, but take the shot out.
Especially with Oscar Allen having a stage, he's having a very definitely going to have an open shot where you know it's going to be a high percentage one. Just slightly over the line. Letting Allen with it, punch it over to Mike Green. Mike Green able to get up and pick up for a miss. Move it. Oh, nearly running the goal off that. Went past, but went right outside. So 16-20 left to play. Adrian looking at clear. Coming too well for a very, very tough ride right there. Looking to move. Going to take it herself. Quickly double team, able to go by it. Great interception there, number 15. Doing good speed there. Six patients there, and she's able to get it.
That was a great header right there.
That's going to be just the third missed clear for the Yale women. My dream going to pass out for herself, number 16, with Marcy. She's able to take it down. Fight about the shot, and she's going to back that out. It's going to be a foul against the Yale women. 14:35. We're going to have a chance to get some opportunity right here. Got up close to the right post. Down by two. This will be a big one. She's waiting. She's going to go. She's going to shoot. Another save. She is having herself a heck of a going goal right there. Really intercepted. Ludwig with the ball. She's going to get it. 1-on-1. And that's going to be a shot. That's going to be a score for the good girls. 14-18. They're going to take a 9-8 against it right here.
That was great intercepted by Taylor Ludwig. They intercepted him to Cleveland right off the tee. Grabbed it. Passed and then we have a goal.
That's a goal. It was 14-18. Denison Big Red is down by one. That's going to have the Oberlin Tigers Yale women take their first time out of the second half. With that, we're going to take our own time out. We're going to be right back on the Denison Sports Network. Thanks for watching. And welcome back. This is Nick Morton alongside Lily Greenhead. We're coming back to a 14-18 left in this one to play. Yale women leading this one 9-8 as a Yale Denison Big Red. We're going to come off of an Oberlin timeout and come to the draw. Big storyline here, draws have run in favor, big time for the Big Red, as they're now on a 12-6 advantage in draw control, makes that 13-6. So we get a soft start here for the Big Red, this is number 21, Tony Margine, she's got speed, she's going to take that right down, she's going to take it right down behind the goal after. She can move up in the 19 moves, where she's not caught, that's going to be a foul against the Yale women instead, so she's going to get her first three position opportunity. She's ready. She's going to go. She's going to go high low. And that's going to tie us up at 9. 13:49 left to play.
This is going to go down there. It's really hard to time to get it up.
I wish that we had time to get it up since that was a time goal. So.
I would. It makes sense.
It does make sense. So the goal is confirmed. 13:49 tied up at 9. And come back up to the draw. So two quick goals there by Denison Big Red. The Tigers came back up. Essentially, it's 0-0 once again. 13:49, plenty of time for either team to go on a run. Or we may just see a back-and-forth game for the rest of the time.
Really great competitive matchup we have right here. Both ends have to work hard out, defensively and offensively.
The ball's still on the ground. And the air and the ground, it's back-and-forth. That's going to go to Justin Big Red after the scoop and the foul. Even on the 14th draw control, it's going to be 3 in a row for him. Thanks for the move there from the defender. One half that over number 19 from Israel. He's looking to bring it down. No rush here as they just tied it up, but obviously the momentum comes down their way. And they can feel that, so he's going to work it around until they have the shot that they want. Taking their time, working behind the goal. And moving on. All that pressure there, there's going to be a foul against the Yale women. Stick to the Big Red. Score 47 left to play.
I'm going to go Yale women. Card turn, pushing ahead of them.
It's going to be Yale card against number 5, Haley Jackson. The 12:47 must play. The Big Red and a great opportunity here to put one in the back for net. Waiting for the whistle. She's going to go. She's going to have a low angle. She's going to back that one out. Pass that over to Tony Margine. She's going to leave her way in and out. She doesn't like what she has. She's going to pass that back out. Try to push Red low. Taking a move. Two great cuts right there. Just the pass over is too tight. So it's five against it. She's going to look around the right eye. Getting behind the goal. Seeing if they can do something here. Maybe some cuts from up top. They might look like there's some kicks and cuts off each other in the middle. Allen with it now. Nice cut from behind the goal, and that's going to be a shot. That's going to be a score to give the Big Red a 10-9 lead.
Well, that's exactly what it was. Clap had the winning space, so the rest of the team is kind of looking off the side, and then we're really able to kind of get the crease and get the top shot first.
big goal right there, going to give them the lead. It's 12-15 left to play. Some like they walk perfectly with the analysis that they're pretty goal to watch. You can see it kind of the whole way. At least my practice here. I'm sitting here with the funny down there. You don't see it coming at all. Going to come up with a minute draw right here. Ball can be in the air. Ball's going to fall out. Looks like number two ball. It's going to be able to get that down ball. Ball's going to ground number 11. I'm going to get that one. Pass that over to number 7, Hershey. Taking it down his shot. Taking it in the offensive zone. Yet another draw clear. The draw control, excuse me. For the big red. Shooting face ball.
I really thought like a dangerous spot right there for the moment in Izzy Pelican and the fact that an Oberlin player, I would say. So that would be a kind of piece of them.
She is not too happy with herself on that one, so she's going to take her seat in the swim bin. Big fan of that word, and that really is too. Looking to clear up, going to take a few ball away with it. She's going to take that herself. She's got speed. She's moving right down the middle, weaving her way in and out of traffic. She has opportunity to take it down herself. She's put her hands right about it. She's going to get pushed right out. There's going to be a foul. That's going to be going to Big Red. It's going to be a three position opportunity here for 11:36 left to play. Everyone down by one. Take a few ball away with the chance. That's going to be a great save by number 30, excuse me, yes, number 33, Hannah Jones. Like I said, there's a lot of threes out in the field. Number 33 shot it, and number 33 saved it. So, there we go. Number 33 for this opportunity here for the young women. So you don't like where they set up, we're going to move them. Now it seems like they're ready. We're going to take this one from the right post. Let's move. You're going to see this one go wide left off the bounce. Back up is there. Going to stick it over him. Going to bring this one in from out of bounds. Looking the left out of there now. Pass it up to number 20, Walker. Oh, quickly stick field, he's now in the right eye. Back behind the goal. See if they want some catch, or if they're just going to pass it around or not. Trying to roll the feet. Start the double with those, try to jump it, that's going to be a foul. And go against the big red. Giving number 5, here he's left him. Can't see for this opportunity. .44 left to play. 10-9. Has the opportunity. You can see that's going to bounce wide left. Great race for the ball out of bounds. However, it's going to stick with the young women. They're going to bring that one in, looking at his competitors in front for it. Instead, it's going to flip a counter. Number 33, Barlow, she's looking for pressure. Looking for pressure, she's going to get ridden right back behind the goal. Looks all over. She's looking for pressure. If I drop him with it, she's going to my guy. Great defense there by the boy. Ball's going up on the ground. Pretty long with the transport. She got it. She's going to be pushed. Right. She's going to step over the line. That's going to go. So far, it's against the big red and six possessions for the women.
Okay, no opportunity to make one for the women. We're going to be looking for a fundamental moment and so big red is going to be a good job to them to keep that restriction covered.
With the moves, they're going to work behind the goal right now. A lot of traffic in the middle of the field right here. Number 32, Barlow's a great shot. The goal on the save. Ball's going to run down the middle. Another opportunity. again, we got big right there and took the ball to go safe. And get that one-on-one save. Looking clear right here. Big Red still moving. They're looking under the offensive zone right now. He has that three in the offensive zone. He's going to drop it. That's going to be a foul and illegal check. Going to make the Big Red 12 for 13 on clearing today. Just an unreal number. Can't ask for much more than that. Also said, but third red leg going to take it in. Ball's going up on the ground. He's going to be able to get it on the ground ball, however. He's going to work that around. Put it over to Israel. Over to Walsh. He's going to drift it around. He's going to get up the play. Still moving it around. That's going to end up on the ground. Joe going to be able to take it. Looking for the clear. Five drops and going to pass that one over. So under 8:30 to play. Pass that over. They're going to work that back on them to go as they usually do. Once again, Denison leading 10-9. 8 minutes left to play. Next one, there's not a ton of time, but at some point, Tom's going to wind down. There's definitely a sense of urgency. You can feel that on the field by both teams. Nice little roll out there, the nice little two to ball. Moving faster. Fireball is going to push it right down the alley. Chance to push back behind the goal. She's going to bring it around the other side. Get that over to two to ball. Skipping field once more. It was some type of interior cutting, but the off-ball man defense was phenomenal by Big Red. See a nice cut right there by number 33 Barlow. Ball's going up on the ground.
Big cut right there by number 99.
And that's going to be a loose ball pushed against the young women. So any Mario's going to get it.
So that is first for Atlanta. Keep up the great plays in terms of the place.
That's going to be a very easy clear right there. And really, you know what speed does, right? It clears. So there it is. Yes, there is. Maybe on the front it will say speed clear and on the back possession is named again.
Yeah.
Well, folks, you heard it here first. These plays are coming out very soon, I promise. So it'll be something I'll really find on the next get home game here.
Both teams are doing a great job of finding a balance between patience and urgency and setting it down. Really kind of look around and make sure that they're all put together in a great spot so they don't kind of force anything. They're also trying to get them in through this within a 6 minute section game.
And now, Big Red, with that one goal lead, they're going to pass the round. It's going to take 6.5 right now. Allen with the ball, and work that back behind the goal. No reason to push anything, just waiting for their shot. Take out as much time as they can. They're playing very spread out. They're in realizing that, taking such pressure. That's going to leave open some touch. Also, some room for error. That ball is going up on the ground. Big Red's going to be able to keep that one. Working that back behind the goal. Looking for the cutter. How do two walls just gonna handle it? 17 Hamilton, we're gonna take back from the top, pass over to 19 Israel. Nice cut there in the middle. Israel passed, wasn't able to get to work, but luckily Big Red can be able to get that ground ball once more. And we have an Allen to go. With the move, he's gonna pass over to Israel. Israel has a ring. Ball on the ground, that's gonna be an illegal check against the young woman. And stick it to Big Red. Nice cutting right there. We're down to 5.5 minutes left to play. So we're with this. We're going to take it back out. We had absolutely zero under there. Such a smart play. And we're with this. Passing around. Fun little game of pass and catch right now.
Touch if I'm going to do a pass and catch, so pass it and move. great thing for them.
And Martin Israel, she's got a team. She's thinking about taking it, which she does. She's going to keep it back up. Now, here's the question from the game when he's going to five. This is a great pass. He's going to try to both of them on the ground. That's going to end up in the stick of the goalie, but enchilada for the gay women. Great check right there, just ball on the ground. We take 4:45.
Really good entry for the Oberlin team. It's a big game.
Now they're looking to clear. Maybe a big clear here for the gay women. And the big red can get the rally, that'd be huge clear. Ball's going up on the ground. She's able to get it right back there. That's going to be a successful clear for the gay women. They're going to be the offensive zone. He's worked under 4.5 to play. Look down, that's going to be a block and really good check there against the Denison Big Red. He's going to take that one for a shot. 4:19 to play. Oberlin down by one. Going to take it in. That's going to be a very hard check there. Have a big red, and it's not just clean our first feet, that's going to be first feet position from the shift.
Yeah, that's definitely also looking for the horizontal crosses, if you submit names out horizontally, you'll get the cover.
And big stop there by number 33, Hannah Gorin. She stepped out towards the top of the crease, and she made herself a very big red, giving her almost no space to have a shot. Big run ball here, Gorin Hannah got that one, it's 1-4. Going to be an immediate check there, giving the Gay Women another free position opportunity from the stick, from the number 20, Walker. After a ton of space, so she's looking to use it. She's going to come out. Great stop there by number 30 from the Gay Women. Both on the back and stick of the Gay Women there. Ball on the ground. Big run ball. She's back there. She's going to get doubled. She's going to get pushed out of bounds. And there's going to be a foul that's going to go against the big red, so nearly a turnover. But the foul is going to keep the Yale women with possession. Rolling three, pretty underhand shot to tie this up at 3:34.
I don't know if that in the goal for Oberlin, you guys have credit to a big red defense, so it's going to really work and highlight the pass. And even on the free position, they're going to get this system and help handle it to save.
There's going to be a big goal as they tie it up. Great defense there for a long time. They have a pretty long possession there for Oberlin, so eventually they're going to get a really nice shot. He's able to roll the crease pretty well right there. But
and then you get it in quite well, which is a hard punch there, though.
It is a big finish right there. So 3:34 left to play. We are knotted up a tie, and now the snow is starting to come down. Going to add to that intensity of this finish right here.
Oh, man.
What was the movie you compared to?
Oh, Die Hard. Just Die Hard 2.
Bruce Willis is making his return to Granville, Ohio. Off the draw, ball's going to be in the air. They can get possession. The Yale women get that one. 17 Hamilton on the defense. It's going to be number 5. Jackson is going to pass that over. Yale women make him bring it down. They're going to get that on the offensive zone. Snow is coming down in steep, so I don't see if that affects the game at all. As we approach 3 minutes to play, now that's a time. Gay women working this one up from the top. Nearly all of them land up on the left side here, looking like it's going to be a play. Now they start to push back in the more conventional offense. Put play over number 33 baller.
Big red right now, they're definitely going to want to be standing right. Pressure on the ball, they pass the 12, trying to get the ball back so they can really know them for the time.
Number 10 Baker, they're looking new there, and they're looking to hit somebody on skate. What is that back off as we're taking 220 left for a mission? Baker's again, they pass it over number 20 Rock. Rocky, excuse me.
Looks like Oberlin is trying to wind down the clock before they can get the most shot off.
They're tied game, there's no reason to push anything. They have possession, they've been able to, if he's won possession, score at the end, so they're just waiting to have their open cut, see if they can deal with it. Going to move around there, there's a little bit of pressure here from the big red. instead of pushing, they're just still going to take their time with it. Here's a quick double. Ball's going up on the ground. Beautiful check right there. Looking to get it. That's going to go out of bounds. Or it's not. Excuse me. Still going to go. That's going to be a foul against the Yale women. Down in the corner. With a minute 30 left to play. Big red and opportunity to stay right here.
I think the kids playing for an hour took the 13 for last year and get it quickly down to the other end and hopefully get the win there.
I'd like that too, I'm not going to lie to you. It's a pretty nice finish.
Sounds like a good one to see Die Hard 2 in a while. I
haven't seen Die Hard 2 in a while, but I'm pretty sure it resembles something like this. But considering it's Die Hard 3, I think you see this win. So. American sitting on the 13 foul line. Ball's going to be on the ground. The goal line's way out of the goal. She's going to have to get back in it. They're going to get the ball. There's going to be a whistle. It's going to be a foul against the big red.
That's important, even though trying to be aggressive, making sure that you can stick to a legal chest or anything. Finding position for your team right now.
We're under a minute to play. They're going to get the ball. Tied in at 10. And the phone is out with it. She's looking to move it. Four seconds to play. Since the agency by both teams, we're down to 30. Looks like now we're going to get a little bit of push here for the Yale women. 4-2 ball with it. Down to 20 seconds. Could be that ball's going up on the ground. It's going to be a nice ground ball right there. Player's going to hit the turf. So it looks like it's going to be a card. That's going to be a card against the Yale women. Big card right here. Looking for a number. That looks like number 8. Maggie Ward. She's going to take a seat. 13 seconds left to play, 9 left to 10, and the 23 is Grace DeVula with her. She's going to run as fast as she can. She's coming up, we're at 9, and pass that up to number 6, Clay Redlow. We're at 5 seconds. She's going to pass that quickly over. Oh, and there is the opportunity. Ball's going to end up on the ground as time expires. That could have been something really special. Ball was a little behind her. Wasn't able to clear the cut. Clear the cut.
And one of those are speed kills, but like they're driving faster than the other. So, like the same thing, they're like trying to get those really speed passes and trying to take up all that space.
It is, so. Regulation was not enough time to decide this one, so 10-10.
They're going to overtime.
They're going to overtime. Pretty sure it's like Buffalo Wild Wings right now, so. And this one, we're going to take a quick timeout as both teams get ready here. So, thank you for watching the Denison Sports Network. We'll be right back. Welcome back. I'm Nick Morton, joining alongside Haley Greenhead as we are getting started to have this overtime period. For those of you at home in women's lacrosse, it's going to be a 6-minute overtime period. It is not sudden victory, so we will take all 6 minutes. At the 3-minute marker, there will be a second draw control. To ensure the both teams have an equal opportunity off of the draw to have their opportunity for a fast break and therefore a score. So at the end of 60, it wasn't enough time. We're going to need another 6 minutes to figure out this one. And we may need a little bit more time than that. We'll see what happens here.
Hopefully, we can, the team will just present them and be able to take control of the game. And then we'll see what happens in 6 minutes.
So, both coaches to play their final. Little talk to their team. As both teams enter onto the field, going towards their respective goals. See what they can do here with this one. It'll be 6 minutes to the 5-3 of this game. One team's going to walk out of here with an undefeated conference record. The other going to add a loss to their resume. It's not as scary as it seems, but could be. We're going to go off the face here.
So it's 3 minutes, 11 o'clock.
and we are ready to go. So, all ready? Somebody's coming down. Just add me back in time once more.
We need to go spend a really feeling right when we're live enthusiasm on the field.
Put a 50-cent song playing right before this one, and you can see both ones are really good in the back. So, nothing pumped up women's lacrosse teams at all 50 cents. So, the draw's off. Up in the next team, she's going to see how he walks. He's going to take that down for the big red. Put the work around. Thompson is really a fast physical move. Going to get that down to number 7, Hershey. Going to get that back behind the goal. Taking it on slowly. Quite a lot of movement right there, but Bob Gunther can pass it over to Israel. Israel with a nice pass over to number 7, Hershey. It's going to be a foul. So that's going to go against the young woman. Get another 7. Really healthy, a free swift opportunity here. She's going to line up to the right post. With 2:25 left to play in the first half of the overtime period. She's going to take it in. She's going to switch hands. She's going to shoot. She's going to end up on the ground. That's going to be a foul going against the yellow woman. She's a little afraid to get up. Coach definitely got to be cold and pretty hard, but glad to see she's okay. She's getting up.
I'm just thinking they're coming right now. Just trying to see the yellow card for. Yeah, I took your head.
That's going to be another big card there. That's going to go in favor of the big red. Number 7, Reed Hershey. She's going to take her second free to this opportunity in a row right here. She's going to take this one right from the middle. 2:20 left to play. She's set. She's going to go down. She's going to shoot. It's going to be another save. And number 32, Alexa Enchilada for the Oberlin Yellow Women.
This gives the big red an opportunity to take me to the middle of that situation and really double team the players.
Nothing. Phenomenal interception right there. What a great save. Also the question, what's going to be a goal for the Denison Big Red? That was a crazy series of events right there. So that's going to give them the lead.
Yeah, I can't remember with a great interception right there. Great pass. It didn't work out for Denison that was Virginia Hamilton right there. He hit the ground earlier. It was really something. Long ground side on the field. But in the end, it was really fast.
Excuse me, trying to figure out what's going on here.
Oh,
that's bugging.
Yeah, it is bugging.
Excuse me, we had a, information was a little different. Rules are consistently changing every time in college sports, so. Excuse me, that's going to be the ball game. That's going to be the more exciting thing for him to get us a big leg. Woo! So that's going to be a big one. That's going to be number 11, Taylor Allen. Taylor Allen, putting up goal number 11 for the Denison Big Red to propel them to victory. This is going to be a 2-0 start in NCAA first.
There's definitely Taylor Allen going back. Lee Allen. Amazing finish for the Big Red.
I have a crazy play right there. It's even more exciting now. They get a 7-0 goal to give them victory. I apologize for our information prior to this, but that's what we're going to go with. So, regardless, that's going to give the Denison Big Red the victory right here. Number 11, Taylor Allen with the heroic score at the end. 3-3 event.
I also played Red Bull Taylor. Yeah, that'll go.
Right here, even right there at the end. Regardless, that's going to give them a 2-0 record. In conference play, preparing them to 5-5 overall. Oberlin Yellow Women going to fall to 7-4, 2-1 in the NCAA. We'll be able to catch me and my co-host, Lily Greenhead, April 13th at 6 p.m. as the visiting Research College comes to visit. We going from Big Red. That will be the third and final game of the season homestand for Big Red. See if they can take a 3-0 start in NCAA play. Until then, thanks for watching. I think you've done some sports networks. This is Nick Morton alongside Lily Greenhead. We will see you all April 13th. Have a good rest of your Saturday.